Dear odd friends, I would like to introduce to you what is Rashtriya Isai Mahasangh and how did it all began. It's a question very often people ask each other. What is this organization? Rashtriya Isai Mahasangh is an organization specially aimed to create a political awareness in the Christian community. The Constitution of India, you know, very clearly instructs its citizens that it has to work towards democracy of the country. So the Rashtriya Isai Mahasangh, as per the Constitution of India, is helping Christians to become more part and parcel of the democratic process of India. How do they contribute? By taking active part in the political scenario. It may be a electoral politics, it may be a party-based politics. In whatever form it is possible, every Christian is advised to take part in the democratic process of the country. Now let me come back to the beginning of Rashtriya Isai Mahasangh. It was the fake end of 2003. Anti-Christian riots began in Jabua district. Very specially, the intensity was felt in Alirajpur Sahib, Jobat, in this area. So it from 2003, it slowly picked up into 2004, and 4 we faced major riot. Many churches were burned down. Many people got affected. So in 2004. We realized that we needed to improve our political participation in the democratic process of the country. Whichever party people may like, they must join. That they must express their views in the political forums. For this aim, we started Madhya Pradesh Chhattisgarh Christian Forum. But very unfortunately, this forum could not work well. Due to some personal interest of people, we had to wind up that. Then we began to make studies on successful organizations working in the country and elsewhere. What is the basic principle that working behind them? Then accordingly, we designed Isai Mahasangh. That was in 2007. We began to work on Isai Mahasangh and it was named Madhya Pradesh Isai Mahasangh. Then it started, you know, to work well, and as per we imagined, we had people in Madhya Pradesh Assembly, in local bodies, panchayats, and in many other scenarios, we got people into the political, electoral politics as well as the party. It became a success. So from many places, people began to ask whether they can also start this organization elsewhere, whether we would give them an ideological support. Because Rashtriya Isai Mahasangh was never meant to create an NGO culture, that is collect funds and distribute to people, conduct programs. No, it was not our aim. We never wanted that. So this was a movement we started. It's an ideology that we are given to people to support our Christians to enter into politics. Let them be in any denomination, but they can be part of the political system. They can be part of the electoral politics. They need to be working well. And it's an example in Madhya Pradesh, a person who became the member of the legislative assembly. In his constituency, hardly few families are there, but he is the member of the assembly, even today. It is because of his, you know, entering into the normal political field without based on caste, creed, religion, he entered into. So in 2012, we held a national consultation in Delhi, YMCA building. Then from there, we began to explore the possibilities of expansion of ESAI Mahasangha. Then from 13, we renamed it, very specially in the Lucknow meeting. It was a huge gathering in Lucknow in which we called it Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha, because it was becoming a national organization, so it became a Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha. We wanted to amend the constitution, change the name. We approached the Friends and Society to change the name. They said it's not possible to add the word national because this word has been reserved by the government of India and you can't add that. Then we also tried to do this through Section 8 Company Act, whether we can, as a charitable company, we can register. We got the same answer from there also. Meanwhile, we thought it's better we register it under the title. We only actually wanted a title because the organization was working. So the title registration process we wanted to start. So we gave all the papers to the Delhi team. Delhi team to start working. And they were very eager to do that. But later in 2018, we realized the team that got all our documents had not worked it well, and they were rather not working at all. So we entrusted all this work to the former president of Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha India. He got through that project. Every process was done. Then we came to know in Delhi, someone who was earlier associated with Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha got a trust registered in Delhi in the name of Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha, and lot of donations are being collected from different parties. We approached the police and an inquiry was ordered. We had to take the help of the police because of certain, you know, malpractices, duplication of names. So it became necessary for us that today we are working into many states of the country. We are actually concentrating mainly on states where Christian population is very less. Because wherever Christian population is there, the voice of Christians are heard in all fields of life. But very specially in the north, west and the central India, where we don't have Christian population. But we are trying to make our presence felt by encouraging people, be in any denomination, how they can get into political. This is in short how this organization started. In our other episode, I would also be giving you a clear view of what is the difference between Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha and other NGOs. This will be given in the other episode. Thanks for listening, friends. Kindly forward this to all our people who want to join Rashtriya ESAI Mahasangha.